there. My name is Megan Severson, and I work with the organization Environment America. We work to protect our air, our water, and the special places that we love, like parks and forests. I live in Madison, Wisconsin, and today I'm just really happy to share with you a little bit about Earth Day, and hope that it helps give you some more ideas and resources to work with as you celebrate Earth Day this year. And in particularly in this time right now, I think that we need some ideas for things we can do at home and in our virtual classrooms. So towards the end of this video, I'm gonna share some tips for how you can do an energy audit of your house to cut down on energy waste. And then you can also check out some more ideas that we have with Environment America through our Nifty 50 list, 50 environmental activities that you can do at home in honor of the 50th birthday of Earth Day. And then we also have another resource page you can check out called Greener Together. It has music ideas, books you can read, movie ideas, and other resources to check out. So for me, Earth Day is really special because it's a time when we can stop and think about all the wonderful things that this planet provides us with. And then we can also learn about, a lot of the history of pollution and things that we can do and need to do to protect the planet for years to come. Earth Day is on April 22nd, and it's a special day. It's one of my favorite holidays. The first Earth Day was 50 years ago in 1970, and it really is considered the birth of the environmental movement. So before 1970, the health of the environment was really not something that a lot of people thought much about, not the way it is now. So big industries were putting chemicals and smoke into our air and water without a lot of, monitoring. And that has really hurt the environment and the people and animals living all around that pollution. In 1962, many of you may have already read this, but a woman named Rachel Carson, who was an ecologist from Pennsylvania, published a really important book called Silent Spring. This book helped to raise public awareness of environmental concerns and how the things that we do as humans have an impact on the natural world around us. If you haven't already, I really encourage you to read that book or reread it in honor of the 50th Earth Day. And then in 1969, there was an oil spill in the ocean off the coast of Santa Barbara. In response, young people, college students, and other people across the country organized a national demonstration against pollution and damage to our environment. And that protest was held on April 22nd, 1970. This was the first Earth Day. Over 20 million Americans joined that demonstration in support of a healthier environment and better treatment of our planet. And it worked. So because people continued to make their voices heard, we now have cleaner air and cleaner water and a healthier environment. But we do still have a lot of work to do, as I think you all know, and we need to do more work to really rein in the pollution that's affecting our air, our water, our animals, and our health. So there are a lot of ways that you can help make a healthier planet, and in honor of Earth Day's 50th birthday, we put together a list of 50 environmental activities you can do in your own home right now. You may have lots more ideas. The sky is really the limit. And one of the things I thought would be helpful for middle school and high school age students would be to do an energy audit of your own house. So by understanding how we consume energy in our own homes, we can better understand how to reduce energy use in our communities, in our state, and across the country. So to get started, you can check out our Citizen's Guide to Reducing Energy Waste. We've linked here below the video. You can learn ways in that on how to make your home more energy efficient. So using the guide, you can implement effective ways to cut down on your energy use. So things that have helped me are things like unplugging my chargers when I'm not using them, changing the heat settings in the washing machine, or if you have a dishwasher, things that you can do to just cut down on some of the electricity use. And you can watch this video here to learn how my colleague Jamie learns how to address where air is escaping from doors and windows in her home.
So it turns out you can save a bunch of money month to month by doing a self-energy audit of your own home. Step 1, close all windows and doors. Don't forget any. Step 2, turn off AC. Step 3, turn on your dryer. Now for the fun part. Take any piece of paper, stick it in a crack, and pull it out. If it doesn't rip, you have an air leak. Time to make some changes in my house and save some money and some energy.
So then while you're going through your home and conducting this energy audit, there are a few things you can talk about either with someone in your household or in your online class. One is, what are the ways that you can reduce energy use in your home today? Are there two ways, three ways, things that you can do to reduce electricity use? The second is, what are other long-term ways that you can reduce your home's energy use? So maybe it's something like getting more insulation for the attic, or increasing the amount of kind of caulking around windows to help preventing air from leaking out. So what are some of the things that you would like to do in the home longer term, but maybe you can't do it today? And then another question is kind of from understanding energy use in your own house, what are some of the ways your community, state, or businesses are working to reduce their own energy waste? And then how can we help them or encourage them or push them to cut down on energy use? So all of these things will help you understand how we are using energy in our homes, ways we can be smarter about it, and ways that we can help our planet to reduce emissions and to help protect our health. So I hope you like this project. Of course, you can check out Environment America's Nifty 50 and Greener Together pages for more ideas. And then please share your ideas, your pictures with your classmates, and link to them at the bottom of this page. We'd love to see what you come up with. Thanks so much, and I hope you have a really great Earth Day. Bye.